Hello everyone and welcome back for another kit review. This just hot off the UPS truck from Round 2 Models is their 1/25th scale 1964 Chevy Impala SS. Yes, this is back in production. It is a 3-in-1 kit. You can do custom, you can do stock, and you can do racing. Yeah, we got a lot of parts in this one. And of course, being a 64 Impala SS, you could also use this as a wonderful base to build the Love Machine from Cheech and Chong. So if you wanted to do that, I'm not going to do it this round. I know this kit will be released in another series. So we know that if we wanted to build it another time, we could easily build it up as the Love Machine. Get the parts online. This one gets you really, really close to the movie car as it is. Let's start taking a look at the parts that are in the box when you get yours. I will link down in the description where you can snag yours on pre-order. First up will be this optional hood scoop. It is just loose in the bag, so be careful with it. Don't lose it. It's got that center support there. You could either leave that in or cut it out, depending on what kind of look you want on your vehicle. Then we've got our engine here. I'm going to guess this is a 409. I didn't look carefully enough in the directions or at the box, but just based on the valve covers, that's what I'm going to guess is under the hood. Engine and transmission, we got a stock air cleaner, oil pan, valve covers. Got a couple different intakes here for blower. We got a custom steering wheel on there. We've got axle placements, raised or lowered, which again helps you do that Love Machine. Blower belt on there, stock manifolds. We've even got a little battery in there, 64 license plates, a bracket on that actually for an alternator. That's pretty surprising in a lot of these older kits. So we can check out all the sweet parts on there. Then we will move over. We've got a convertible top option, stock dashboard, stock steering wheel, seat belts, extra harness for the race version. We've got our roll cage and parts for that on the side there. On this one here, we've got a part that I have no idea what it is, but I'm sure I will find out what it is. We've got bucket seats, wheel backs, wheel rings, stock hood. Nice big slab hood underneath. You can see it's pre-grooved. If you want to cut it out for that hood scoop or cut it out for a blower option that we saw on there, or just leave it as it is, nice and smooth. On this one here, we've got some custom seating options. We've got another hood scoop, much larger, much taller. We got custom exhaust system. We've got custom pans for the bodywork. If you want to go full custom, there's another set of parts right there. Here we've got our firewall, which is quite detailed. Much more detailed than I ever expected it to be. Radiator, horn mount, more wheel rings, and what it looks like, possible hood hinges or axle placement on there. I'm not really sure. Or maybe for a tow bar, like we did on the other kit. On our chassis here, you can see this is a very promo style. We've got our full exhaust system molded in. We've got our frame, fuel tank, trunk area, front suspension, rear drive line, even the link and everything is all molded in. Strong detail, but all molded in. And then we've got our axle placement here, excuse me, for that chassis. We've got a one-piece interior tub, door panels. You can hear it's got the detail in there. Kind of hard to see on camera. Center console is molded in. Definite promo style mounting lugs to the body. Got our pedals molded in and carpet detail on the inside. Finally up for this section is the 64 Impala body. Make sure to remove these carefully. If your cutters get in here too far, you could split this pillar. All molded in, radiator support. Careful if you're going to cut these nubs off. That is your hood support on the car. Looks like we've got sort of a vinyl top on there. You can see the ridges. Nice molding on that trim work. You can see up there, it's prominent. We can get our chrome pens on there. Impala logos, door panels, Impala logos on the trunk, all the way around. Got this all molded in as one piece with our Chevy logo, all the way around the back. The trim on this is scale size and prominent enough that we can get our marker in there. Nice looking body, and it's a big body too. Looks great, makes for a cool ride. Now let's switch to the other side of the table in transparencies. We've got our front and back glass. Easy enough to spot, nice and clear. Not much distortion on those, even though it is older style. We've got two sets of transparent reds. We've got our stock taillights. We've got our customs. Then we've got some metal work. We've got two chrome axles. And this nice little clip. This might be for the hood or something. But that's in there, so don't lose that. We've got a beautiful set of decals in this kit. All kinds of factory emblems. Logos, Chevy logos, door and console badges. We've got a tack. We've got interior door lights, air filter logos, marker lights, steering wheel hubs, radio, stock wheel hubs, gauge cluster, emblems. All the Impala SS emblems in left and right. They're not identical. They actually fix that on there. We've got a buttload of license plates. We've got some cool sponsor logos, bad news logos, drive us nervous wrecks. Get it? 427, so obviously it's 427. My mistake. AXS, we got some cat logos, twister logos, nice looking water slide decal sheet. Definitely will have leftover parts from that. We've got one and two entire chrome trees. This one is just a set of nice wheels with knockoffs. Beautiful set of optional wheels there. Full on customs. Love that stuff. We've got our stock grill and bumper. We've got our custom grill. Stock wheels. Custom wheels. We've got blower parts. We've got custom valve covers. Oil pan all thinned. We've got trim work, we've got blower scoops on there. That is a lot of stuff on that chrome tree. All kinds of parts left over if you want to have those. Tons and tons of stuff. And we're not done. That's not all that's in the kit. We've got one pair of tires, two pair of tires, two more pair of tires. We've got two complete sets and drag tires in this kit. First up will be some nice Goodyears. These would have been sweet tires to throw in that Challenger kit as well, and they would fit. So if you have that Challenger kit, you get these, they will swap out directly, and you can throw some white letter Goodyear tires on there. Beautiful tires, pad printed, don't have to do any extra work. Then we go to the stock white walls, bias plies, black wall on the other side, beautiful tires, semi-solid. Nice looking, always excellent. You get so many tires in AMT kits usually. And finally, really, really nice Racemaster dragsters. Pad printed, sharp looking, semi-solid tire. These sand down and look so authentic. Black wall if you're not into the Racemasters. But yeah, gorgeous. So we get all that stuff in this kit, including all these tires, which usually cost you about 10, 15 bucks in a parts pack, if not more. I'm going to get to gluing together my 64 Impala, and I'll see you in just a moment. The build session on this goes even easier than on the last kit we just built for the Wednesday video. Everything glues together so quickly and easily. It's not a challenge at all. You can see the axle placement blocks go into the chassis, and then the chassis is ready to go. You could always shave off all this exhaust, clip it, shave it, but you can see it pushes through, so you'd have to fill it in and deal with it that way. Otherwise, we can just do simple work on the chassis and then leave the exhaust in and say maybe they run headers on my version, but they have to keep the stock exhaust mounted up for who knows what. They could make up some weird, goofy rule. We got the body with the firewall. We trimmed out and sanded down the braces for the roof, which I'm glad are there, but we just got to make sure we cut those off and deal with it. And we've got that all set up. Then we've got the custom seats glued together. And the only reason I did that was just so you could get an idea of how those work. And then they have these keyed back pieces that go into this groove back here. And that's in chrome. And it makes up the custom seat back. And you get this kind of cool look to it. So I wanted to glue those together just so you could see how they look. I'm not going to be using them, but it's an optional part, one of the many optional parts. I showed you how to cut open that hood, file it down, and then I scraped off the back seam of the hood, left the front one because it lines up nicely with that center support, glued it in place, and now we have an air scoop. Even if you don't run a blown engine, you can still run an air scoop for air, fresh air. Got the 427 built up with the filler neck, the carburetor, the distributor, and then I put the header blocks on, the header plates on there, and we'll attach the headers, which are cast in chrome, a little bit later. Of course, it's got the big hole for the axle that will go through it, that will hold it in place. A lot of this car, this demonstration, is pretty much an outside of the car. Pop the hood, look, you don't really turn it over, you don't, you know, do that stuff. It builds into a nice looking model on the outside, but not extreme modern detail. You're just not going to have that in this one. We've got the stock air cleaner if you choose to use it on the strip. We've got the battery, stock valve covers if you want to use them. I'm going to use the finned ones. And we've got our radiator, alternator, pulley system, and fan. So you can use that on there. And really, I mean, it doesn't take much. We got our bucket seats. We got our seat belts, jack stand if you choose to use it. Got our wheels. This will be for the drag wheels. These extension on there. And our horns. We've got our custom exhaust system coming off the headers and running to the back sides of the vehicle so we can build ourselves the car that you saw. Now, you could do anything you wanted with these wheels. You can paint them. You can leave them chrome. Do anything you want on your model. Decide how you want it to sit. Everything. They even have headlight covers, headlight blankouts on there. So decide how you want to build up your ride. I've got the interior tub here with our roll bar and its support to keep it from collapsing. It's a super, super easy kit to build so far, not having any issues. I anticipate the end assembly will end up going just the same. But let's find out how we paint it up, how we get some detail on it when I come back. After that nice long detailing section, I was just having so much fun with this car. Things were going good, not having any issues with assemblies and detailing and stuff like that. So when those things go on, I just end up forgetting that I'm still filming while I'm working. I'm enjoying it so much. So we'll wrap up all the things we did in that detail section, and then all I've got to do is the final assembly, which is just pressing the interior into the body and the body onto these large pins on the chassis, and we're all done. So you can take a look. We'll look at the grill here, and I really did like the side box art, so I am replicating as much of that as I choose to and making any different changes that I see fit to my model. But I did the blackout on the inboard headlights and left them open on the outside. I just happen to like that look after I blackwash the grill, and that's what they got going on here. Those would be open for air intakes, but we'll just imitate those with those nice blackouts that they give you, the plastic discs that I painted flat black. We've got our rear bumper, and I just did some basic black wash on it. That will glue in place. On the hood, look how nice that came out after we scraped that seam in the back, but left it on the front so that it lined up, and then put the little front decal on there. You can barely see it, but it's on there. We've got our exhaust dumps done up in a tinted rainbow heat, and then we did the blackouts of the tips. Those all assemble on the bottom of the chassis when we're all done. Pretty much not going to see them except for where they run and come next to the body, because we're not going to be flipping it over. I did zero detail to the bottom of the chassis because of that exhaust molded in. I don't want to draw any attention to it whatsoever. The body, in my opinion, came out awesome. Just awesome. Masked it, chrome trimmed it, did the silver trim, did the decals. They look fantastic, though I did add those decals on the lower fenders on mine just because I wanted to. Did the Gundam marker around the door panel lines, the trunk lid, the gas cap, got the Impala SS logos, used a Sharpie to do the silver in here, then left it gold, tinted in the taillights. Put the Impala SS emblem on. Same on the other side. Got that flat black with the chrome above it. Then what I'll do is I will future floor polish the bottom, the top, and the fenders and stuff, and leave that stripe and the top alone. But that turned out real, real sweet. Nice multi-tone vehicle. You can see I painted the firewall, and then I attached the radiator and the horns underneath. Loving this, having a good time with it. We got the interior done, did it in a high gloss black, did the yellow belts on this one so they stand out, did a chrome roll cage, and did the dashboard up with some paints and hand detailed the door panels. Got all that work done. Again, easy to work on, not a fight, no problem. Even put the old style chrome fire extinguisher on the center console, mounted it there. That will just locate to these panels here. All the tail lights and the windshield pretty much just friction fit into place. I used two drops of super glue on the arms here of the glass just to make sure it didn't collapse in right when I got it all assembled. Then we get to our 427 with those rainbow tinted headers. Got our carburetor on there, oil filler, belt and pulley system, got the custom valve covers, got our distributor on there with shielded, I did it in metal, so it'd be a shielded coil, and that's about all you can see. Transmission, guarded bell housing on there. Then we've got our Mickey Thompsons, which I located in the lower hole underneath just to let it sit down, and on the upper hole they'd be rubbing on the fender. Did the white walls in the front, left them in the stock upper location, which also holds the engine in place, and did absolutely nothing underneath. Not a thing. So it's going to look sweet. I've got to attach the air cleaner and the battery. The air cleaner they'd probably take off when they got to the track, but we'll put it on there just for our model's purposes. This kit has been a pleasure so far. Very easy to work on. No issues, and those decals laid down fantastically. I loved painting the body that gold and then doing the black on it. Really enjoying myself. So I'm going to get some future floor polish on stuff, get final assemblies together, and we'll have it on the turntable next. After a very, very easy final assembly stage, and when I mean easy, the rear bumper glues on right after you press the body onto the chassis. The front bumper and grill presses in. It has a nice friction fit, although I did use a small drop of super glue on either side just to make sure that it didn't come out when we're on the turntable or taking photos. The rear bumper is glued just on the front of the seam there, and it all holds in nice and tight without an issue so far. The interior just snaps into place. I highly recommend putting the dashboard in all the way up to the glass and then centering and pushing it in place against the two large locating holes back behind the package shelf, and you'll get it in. Then I glued the exhaust on the bottom. It's got large pins on it. I probably would cut those down next time to bring it up closer to the body, but it looks pretty cool, and it doesn't touch the ground. You can see it just barely skips across, which is fine for a dragster, definitely not for a streetcar. The hood fits on. You can see the fit on there is beautiful. The 427's under the hood. The dropped front end definitely looks the part of a dragster. And then if I hadn't raised the back end, we wouldn't be seeing a lot of those tires. So I'm glad that I did extended the stock height on the back end and the lowered on the front. I think it gives it just the right amount of stance for this particular 64. The way those headlight blackouts look, like the box art. We got the decals. We got it painted similar to the box art on the side. I'm really digging this ride. So whoever came up with that bad news look on the side of the box really has a winner as far as I'm concerned. It is a tough looking 6.4. It is a nice looking car. You can go lots of ways with this thing. Full on custom, stock, drag racer. I want to see anyone who's ever built the Cheech and Chong Love Machine out of this 64. I want to see what you had going on with that, with the interior and whatnot. When they reissue this kit, I'm sure someday, a few years down the road, instead of this Super Street Rod edition, they'll have another edition that they will release. At that point in time, I will have decided exactly how I want to go with the Cheech and Chong, and it'll give me an opportunity to build that now that I'm familiar with the kit. Now we can go ahead and build it again, just like I've done with the Toyota pickups and other models. They release them, you build them different every time, and enjoy it. So I want to thank Round 2 Models for sending this over. This isn't even on the pre-order lists, but as soon as they're available, I will link down in the description where you can grab yours and have it ready for you. I would assume, even though I don't have any information about this, just guessing that when I receive the box, this should probably be available first quarter of 2024. So, you know, 4-6 weeks maybe, but don't hold me to that because I'm not positive. And if the shipping crates take longer to arrive, you never know what's going to go on. But I would assume first quarter 2024. Maybe we'll get lucky. They'll arrive before the year is out, we don't know. But when this video airs, we're almost halfway through December as it is, and you can definitely, definitely enjoy waiting for this kit and building it up. Don't forget, an entire set of Goodyear pad printed tires, an entire set of the white walls, I used one of them on the front to match the box art, and then a pair of MH Racemasters hanging off the back on those custom wheels, which of course are hollow, so they look nice and black behind them. You can go lots of ways with this kit. You've got that jack, you've got that brake rotor on the chrome tree to simulate like it's being worked on. You could do anything you want with this rad machine. Show me what you're going to do. Tell me what you're going to do with yours in the description. I like hearing about those ideas. Sometimes I steal one or two of them for my next build on a different car, and I will see all of you at the next review.